Dear students, in this video we are going to discuss about two-stroke petrol engines and the differences between a two-stroke engine and a four-stroke engine. Already in the previous video we have seen about four-stroke engine, what is a four-stroke engine and what are the four-stroke petrol engine and diesel engine, how it is functioning, all the things we have seen. So now two-stroke engine means what and how it is going to be function, and what is the difference between the two-stroke and four-stroke that we are going to see in this video. Right, so two-stroke petrol engine. Now in the module 3 we are going to discuss about a two-stroke petrol engine. So petrol engine, already we said petrol engine works on based on auto cycle, and moreover the petrol engine uses the fuel as a petrol, right? So here any engine is a heat engine. What we are saying, the IC engine is a heat engine where the heat energy is converted into rotary motion, okay, mechanical energy. How the heat energy is produced? The heat energy is produced by burning the fuel. How the fuel is getting burnt? So here if you take a petrol engine and we are using petrol inside the engine cylinder. So the first of all, to go for strokes, we should know about the parts of the IC engines. The one is the cylinder and the piston. So piston is moving inside the cylinder, right? And it is the cylinder, the piston is connected with a crankshaft through a connecting rod. So when the crankshaft rotates, the connecting rod pulls the piston downward and it pushes the piston upward. So because of the crankshaft rotation, the piston moves up and down, as well as in reverse we can say, because of the piston moves up and down, the crankshaft is going to rotate. So the whole engine, it's a cycle. One cycle in four stroke engine or two stroke engine, whatever it is. So one cycle in the sense, combustion, suction of fuel, combustion of compression and combustion, then exhaust of the fuel, burnt fuel gases. This is the one cycle. So in four stroke engines, one cycle carries four different strokes. That is the movement of the piston. We know first one is before going for the two stroke engine or four stroke engine, we should understand what is a stroke. Stroke is the movement of the piston from one end to another end. So the length we can call as stroke length. And in two stroke engines, the whole sequence of events, just like I said, no, suction, stroke, compression, power and exhaust strokes, or both are completed only in two strokes, that is two movements of the piston up and down, or we can say as the one full revolution of the crankshaft. Okay, this is the first one. Second one, in case of four stroke, we have seen the valves is the inlet valve and exhaust valves we have seen. So that through the inlet valve, the charge particles get inside when suction strokes takes place. But in this case of two stroke engine, there is no valve present. Instead of valves, we are having two holes called ports. Okay, so here ports is inlet port, exhaust port and a transfer port. Three ports we are there, we are having here, right? So in this sketch we come to know that how the port is going to be open and close, and each and every stroke. So two stroke engine, now as we said, so in the two stroke engine will operate only with the entire cycle is completed within the two strokes, that is upward stroke and downward stroke we call it as. So what do you mean by upward stroke and downward stroke? In the sense, the piston moves from bottom dead center to top dead center. If it moves, we call it as upward stroke. When the piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center, it moves downwards, we call it as downward stroke. So while moving up and downward, what are the operations we are going to see here? It is going to happen. So one thing is, first we said, no, the three main thing is, three main ports are there. One is inlet port, an exhaust port and a transfer port. So I can show this transfer port here. We can see, we can see this is the transfer port here. We can see this transfer port, or else this is transfer port, and here you can see the exhaust port and the inlet port here. Okay, So what will happen when the piston moves downward and piston moves upward? So this is the thing we are going to discuss here. So first thing we should know, what are the two different strokes, then we will see that the image and then come. So upward stroke, where two operations simultaneously, two processes is going to happen. One is suction and compression. When the piston moves upward, it covers two ports and it uncovers one port. That's what here covering and uncovering can be done with the help of the piston movement, not the valves. See, so here there is no valves are here. The ports are only opening and closing with the help of the movement of the pistons. When the piston moves upward, it covers two ports, the exhaust port and the transfer port, which normally almost opposite to each other. So both the exhaust valve and transfer port are getting closed with the help of stroke of the piston when it moves upward. So that time when all the valves or the ports get closed, the charges which is above to the piston will get compresses, okay, and that time it uncovers the suction port. You can see in the picture, first picture I'll show you that. So in this picture we can see that one port, this is the transfer port is getting open, and this another one which is going to open. So when it upward movement takes place, when the upward movement of the piston takes place, the transfer port it is going to be closed, and here at the first stage we can see this inlet port is getting closed. Inlet is getting closed and the exhaust is open and the transfer is open. In the second picture we can say that is the petrol air fuel enters in the inlet port, because the inlet port is open and the transfer port and the exhaust port, which are opposite to each other, are getting closed. When the piston moves upward, the transfer port and the exhaust port is getting closed, so that the there is no movement of fuel takes place from the cylinder to outside, so that the air, which is air fuel mixture, which is present over to the cylinder, over to the piston, is getting compressed, and at the end of compression a spark plug spark is getting introduced by the spark plug. And that again it burnt the gases over there, because already compression is taken place. So once the gases or once the fuel is getting burned, it produces an exert of force over the piston and it pushes downward. That's what now the downward stroke is going to be happen. So when the downward stroke happens, first the piston moves, we can see the piston now in the top. In the second picture, second image, you can see the piston is at the top, and when the piston, when the pressure is created over the piston and it moves downward, the piston moves downward and it opens the exhaust port first, okay, and it opens the exhaust port first. So when it moves the exhaust port, this gas is getting eliminated from this area. So this is the area the exhaust gas is coming out, and then further movement of the piston, the transfer port is getting open. The transfer port, when it gets open, the gases is passed from the bottom through the transfer port above the cylindrical case. So this movement will help us to make the transferring of materials from the fuel charge from the crankcase towards the top of the piston. Again, once the stroke is happening, when again compression takes place, the fuel is getting compressed, and this is a continuous process is going to be taken. So the upward stroke and downward stroke, as we said, the upward stroke, when it moves upward, it closes the exhaust port and transfer port, and at the same time it uncovers the suction port. So fuel gets in, and filled in the crankcase area, where for the next moment, during the downward stroke, the power is created due to the burning of gases, and it pushes downward the piston. So it moves downward and it uncloses the exhaust port and the transfer port, and closes the suction port. So this will happen for the movement of fluid or charge from down to upward. So this is what happening. The entire cycle will happen within two strokes, the downward stroke when the transfer port moves. Okay, so this both the operations can be done within one revolution of the crankshaft. That is, downward stroke and the upward stroke can be taken place only within the 180 degree or 360 degree of a revolution. One full revolution of the crankshaft, both operation can be done. So when downward, it uncovers the first exhaust port and then transfer port. So the gases which comes through the transfer port is come something, it mixes with that exhaust gases and it will leave. So a process we call it as a scavenging takes place, and this some useful gases also, useful charge also, it leaves along with the gases, right? So now we are going to discuss about the four stroke and two stroke engines differences. So one power stroke for every stroke, that's what in four stroke engine. For every stroke, every that is suction stroke, compression stroke, power stroke, exhaust stroke, so one cycle that carries two full revolutions, two full revolution of the crankshaft is equal to is created this one power stroke. Okay, but in two stroke engine, now we have seen one downward stroke and upward stroke within one revolution of the crankshaft, we have get this power stroke. So this is the first difference. For four stroke, two revolution of a crankshaft is needed, but for two stroke engine, only one revolution of the crankshaft is fine enough. And the inlet valves and exhaust valves are present. You can see if you are having the four stroke petrol engine or diesel engine, if you take, there are valves are present, inlet valves and exhaust valve. But in the case of two stroke engine, there are no valves present, only ports present, inlet valve, exhaust port and transfer port. Inlet port, exhaust port and transfer port, three ports will be present. And crank case is not fully closed and airtight, and here it is fully closed and airtight in two stroke engines. And we can see some other differences. The size of the flywheel is larger in case of four stroke engine, but in flywheel of two stroke engine it's very smaller. And fuel consumption, you can say that most of the fuel is not fully consumed in two stroke, that mostly fuels went waste through the exhaust port, but here in four stroke it is possibility of full fuel is getting consumed. And weight, if you check it out, the weight is very high in case of four stroke engine, but in case of two stroke engine the weight is less. And valves, due to presence of valves and presence of what is it, port, we can say the material wear and tear will be more in case of petrol four stroke engines, and in two stroke engine the wear and tear is will be less. And this is the thermal efficiency will be more than in four stroke engine, because all the fuel what we pour is utilized effectively, but in case of two stroke it is won't there. So torque produced will be more in case of four stroke, but in two stroke torque will be less. So these are all some important differences for the four stroke and two stroke engines. Okay, thanks for watching the video. Next class we will see about some other problems related to the efficiency and all. Okay.